Now that we've seen the best practices, let's start to discuss some test smells. And you're gonna see that there is a mapping actually between the good practices and the bad practices. One very common code smell in tests is duplicated code. And this is not surprising, as this smell is also very common in production code. In tests, this happens a lot when multiple tests depend on the same fixture or on small differences over the same fixture. It is very common to developers, instead of coming up with abstractions or utility classes or private methods or any other way to reuse source code, to just duplicate. So every test method has the same block of code. And of course, the impact on the maintenance is the same that when you have this problem in production code, which is if you have to change in one place, you have to change in multiple places. And this is pretty hard to do depending on the size of your test suite. Maybe the changes are not so explicit, so developers change in one place and do not change on the other place. And that is why this is considered a smell. Another very common one is called assertion roulette. And this happens when you have a failed test, and it is very hard for the developers to understand the assertion that is failing. And this can happen for multiple reasons. One of them can be that you have so many assertions on your test that as soon as you have one assertion failing, it is pretty hard to understand its context because there are too many things before the assertion. The other situation where this can happen is when you have an assertion that is so complex that by just looking at it, you cannot grasp what it does. So in this case, maybe adding a comment or a message to this assertion, NJUnit in particular allows you to pass a message to the failing assertion that explains the assertion as a whole. Another common strategy used to developers to sort of avoid this problem is what they call one assertion per method. And the whole idea is that you should have the smallest number possible of assertions in a test method. Some developers take this to the very extreme, and they say that you can only have one assertion per method, really just one assertion. But some other developers are more pragmatic, and they just try to minimize assertion as much as possible. Mostly because if you have many assertions, you can probably break that single test into two, three, four tests. Another very common smell, and we discussed this a bit already, is when you have a very slow test. And slow tests are problematic because developers, they don't want to wait for a long time. So this means that in practice, they won't execute the slow test that often. So they will kind of forget about this test and never run it. And this means less feedback for you as a developer. So as soon as you have a slow test, make sure that you do as much as possible to make this test to be fast again. Finally, the last one in this video is what we call the resource optimism, which is to believe that the resource is always available for your test. For example, your test depends on a database and you have the database in your machine, but your colleague doesn't have it. So the test passes in your machine, but it doesn't pass on your colleague's machine. Or to believe that your resource is 100% available all the time. So web services, they are sometimes not working and you cannot make calls to this web service. If a test runs while the web service is out of service, this test will probably fail. So you basically have two options here. The first one is to avoid using external resources. We already saw how to do it, mock objects. Or the other option, when you can avoid the external resource in the test, is to make sure that the test is resilient enough. Simply providing a message saying, resource is not available, this test can't continue, is definitely better than failing completely. In addition, make sure that all your environments have the required resources. Continuous integration tools like Jenkins, CircleCI, Travis, they can help you in making sure that you always have the same environment when you run the tests.